pray her soul rest in eternal peace. Moving on to tourism, Ugandans are asking the government to prevail over investors in the tourism industry who charge for services in dollars rather than Ugandan shillings. They say away from being scared by the foreign currency, tourism services are too expensive that indigenous Ugandans cannot afford to explore their own country.
Go in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1!
Stop! Ice!
If you want to change your color,
I got the touch.
The public outcry was made during the launch of bungee jumping in Jinja, one of the activities that's yearned for by tourists. Bungee jumping, word over, is one of the activities any tourist would not miss to explore. In Uganda, it was launched last evening in Jinja by Bungee Uganda Limited. Bridget Tushabe was the first Ugandan to have a feel. We trekked with her to see how it's done. She says she had never done it before, although always yearned to explore the bungee.
We've been waiting for this to open up, so finally it's here and we are doing it, so I'm excited. Because this is the only place where you can do bungee in Uganda as of now.
After she was tied and secured by safety belts, she had to jump and touch the Nile waters. Tushabe narrates that it was a wonderful experience that anyone would have take on.
It's my first time doing the bungee. I've always wanted to do it. So this time when it reopened, I got in touch and made reservations. So I encourage anyone that's into adventure, if you want to try something new, because this is the only activity that we have center where you can do the bungee in Uganda. So I encourage you to come through, have fun with friends.
However, with such wonderful tourism activities and sites, domestic tourism still staggers as a few Ugandans can explore their own country. Scores of people put the blame on actors in tourism sector who charge for services in dollar foregoing the Ugandan shilling, currency they say scares indigenous Ugandans.
Just because the prices, basic prices, but mainly lodging prices, because for entrance in tourism, it's a bit cheap, but with transport as well, most people would even try to improvise and use their cars.
Rob Davis, the chief executive officer at Bungee Uganda, says that the business is down due to restrictions on COVID.
I make money for the country, aren't we? You know, this isn't about lining everyone's pockets. You know, if I'm making money here, the government are benefiting in taxes. Yeah? So I really hope that we can relax the rules and bring in the tourists and bring in more money. I mean, for instance, give you an example, just with the bungee, it's $200,000 for a domestic guy to jump at a Ugandan, but it's $115 for a tourist. Now, if it's $115, it's more money, more tax. Yeah? So we need to relax a bit and just allow the... I mean, the tourists are coming. I think you've probably noticed there's more and more slowly coming back.
Martin Mugara, the state minister for tourism, has always made it a point to promote domestic tourism, saying that during his reign, more Ugandans shall have piqued interest in exploring their country.
We've known that it is very important for you, the Ugandans, to travel and make your contribution to the sector. This has been